It's your morning guru in the house, back with another bag on video with a fresh stream, ladies and gentlemen. Arsenal versus Mulder. Of course, Ole Gunnar Solskjaer is definitely going to be pulled back into Mulder because it looks like his Manchester United managerial career is about to come to an end. I just don't want that to happen because, not just because, you know, he's like a clueless manager. No, the problem is that the bunch of lads that he has under him are really a piece of, some are really a piece of shit. And I know that, and I'm pretty much sure Ole Gunnar Solskjaer is not the one to be blamed here. But I will not even blame the owners, but I'm pretty much sure there's just one management person that he should leave. It's about time that he should leave, Ed Woodward, and probably I think he's not the right guy to lead. Because you got to give somebody four seasons or five seasons for a guy like Ole Gunnar Solskjaer to realize what are the worst players of Arsenal. What are the worst players of Manchester United that actually are causing a lot of problems, especially Harry Maguire? He's just a glorified, expensive Phil Jones. That's what he is. But moving on, let's talk about the reality, because Gabriel Magalhães was Arsenal's best summer signing and not Thomas Partey, according to Gary Neville. Now, Gary Neville has said after the victory over Manchester United of Arsenal, he said, Arsenal's defensive performance has been brilliant from front to back, but the back three have been good. Gabriel has been fantastic so far, I'd see. He's been the best player on the pitch for me. Holding's been good in the right centre-back position as well. He was brilliant. Mikel Arteta in the way in which he sets his team up. Aubameyang got the goal which his team deserved. And moving on, let's talk about it, because Mikel Arteta has played down his contribution to Arsenal's upturn in form. He says, no, it's down to the players on how they perform and what they are able to achieve and do on the football pitch. I'm just here, another piece around the club, to help them achieve as much as possible, to give them confidence, to pass on to them my idea of how we have to play, how we have to live together, how I understand this profession, and I know how complicated it is. It's been almost 11 months, almost four of them sitting at home for the first job. I think it's very, very special. And circumstances, and I think we have tried to manage it in the best possible way. I believe a manager, he's been unbelievable, he's been unreal. But moving on, I'll tell you something else is also unreal. David Alaba's price tag, yes. David Alaba is available for £30 million. Yes, £30 million in January. But if David Alaba can actually reach an agreement with another club, he could be available on a free transfer towards the end of the coming summer transfer window. Because there are lots of clubs that are available are actually wanting to sign him. That is Liverpool. And all of David Alaba's other suitors have been made aware that he could be available for £30 million. I hope Arsenal are listening to it, because yes, Bayern Munich are willing to cut their asking price in half for a player who will become a free agent in the summer of 2021, because they'll get some amount of money. £30 million for David Alaba, 28 years of age. I'll take it. Give him some good amount of money. You know, of course, if Arsenal make it into the Champions League, I think Alaba would be a wonderful signing. But moving on, let's talk about it. Arsenal transfer targets. There are lots of rumors about Odson, Edward and Michael Olise. Well, let's talk about one by one, because there are lots of transfer rumors that are suggested, because former Arsenal striker Kevin Campbell has urged his old side, Arsenal, to sign Celtic forward Odson Edward as a replacement for Alexander Lacazette. Yes, the Gunners were one of the numerous Premier League teams linked with the move for Odson Edward over the summer, but Lacazette's future was not at all decided until then. So, Campbell believes that he has to have a say in this matter. He says, there was talk of a move to Arsenal. They have been utilizing Aubameyang from the left, and Lacazette is the one that Edward could come in for. Lacazette is the wrong side of 30 now. That move may still happen because Edward is a really talented player. He is a natural goal scorer who is very cute around the box. A player that would be a great addition to anybody. But for now, he is at a huge club in Celtic. And also Arsenal starlet kiddo Taylor Hart is wanted by numerous clubs. Taylor Hart is yet to sign a professional contract with the Gunners. And a number of clubs from the Premier League, Championship and Bundesliga have made inquiries over the teenager talent. Let's see what happens, because Taylor Hart has scored 4 goals and provided 3 assists for Arsenal under-18 so far this season. He's been good attacking-wise. He's a left-sided attacker. And his improvement in finishing has impressed coaches over the last few months. So let's see. But moving on, well, Michael Olise, well, the Reading talisman, is only £8 million release clause. He has an £8 million release clause in his contract at Reading, according to Football Insider. because the Gunners, Chelsea, Liverpool, Everton, Leeds United, Wolves, Borussia Dortmund, RB Leipzig, AS Monaco and Napoli have all been tracking the 18-year-old, and the teenage sensation has started the season in fine form for the Royals, and his latest development is set to put a host of clubs on alert because Olise has featured 9 times in the championship so far, scoring 2 goals and providing 3 assists in the process. The guy's vision, and of course, £8 million, only £8 million, he could be a bargain. He could be the steal of the century. Just joking. Moving on. Well, Joe Willock has opened up about Mikel Arteta. He says, what he's done over the 10 months he's been here is mind-blowing. And we can only hold our hats off to him. And that's something that we talk about. We talk about the big respect we have for him in the changing room. Of course. But moving on, Arsenal had the ball for 1 minute and 43 seconds before winning their penalty at Man United. It served as the latest example of Mikel Arteta's side manipulating play before pouncing. Now, time and again, Hector Bellerin's awareness is what brings these moves into fruition. So, Hector Bellerin's movement was really important for Arsenal to win that penalty and Aubameyang to score the winner against Manchester United at Old Trafford, breaking the jinx, of course, of winning a game for the first time in 14 years at Old Trafford and, of course, for the first time since January 2015 against the Big Six club. But moving on, Mohamed Elneny in 2015 said, it is my duty to help the team with my strengths, and when my colleagues see how much I'm running, they automatically run more. As a child, I often played on the street for 10 hours or more. I think that's where I learned to run non-stop. And talking about it, Joe Willock has opened up about his future as well. He said, I'm 21 years old and I'm playing for the team I love. I've supported this team my whole life, so I'm not trying to look at it too intensely. I'm just trying to work hard and give the question to the boss overstating me more regularly. My goodness, Joe Willock is the guy. He's the main man, man. I mean, of course, I've always, whenever I've actually come across his interviews, whatever I've heard is, it was always his dream for to play for Arsenal. And he was really great against Dundalk. I'm pretty much sure, Malda, I'm pretty much sure he's going to be starting tonight. But moving on, FIFA President Gianni Infantino receives a written request to change the handball law from UEFA counterpart Alexander Seferin. They are wanting to change the handball law because the change to stop harsh calls, because there are lots of harsh calls and that decides the fate of bigger clubs. And that actually puts a lot of pressure on UEFA president, because the clubs that are actually involved in are huge clubs like PSG, Manchester City, you know. And of course, if you're watching football, you just don't want to see unwanted things like, you know, the blame game goes on. Well, Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang has spoken about Malda. He actually has given his view about the game tonight for Arsenal. He says, I have played against Norwegian sides before, so I know their style of play. We will study Malda closely before the game, but we expect they will come here and go for the 3 points. Because, of course, Malda are a team who have, apart from Arsenal, are the only team in the group B to secure 6 points in their first 2 games, beating Dundalk and, of course, Rapid Vienna. So yes, Molde are really, really strong. And Arsenal are ahead of them in the group because of the goal difference. And talking about more stuff, Ainsley Maitland-Niles, the biggest news. Ainsley Maitland-Niles and Bukayo Saka have been included in the England squad for the upcoming games against Ireland, Belgium and Iceland. That is some awesome news, man. Of course, both of them have been included in the defenders list. But yes, congratulations to Bukayo Saka and Ainsley Maitland-Niles. Love it. You'll always love to see it. But Arsene Wenger, ladies and gentlemen, will take part in FC Barcelona tweeted out. Arsene Wenger will take part in the Sports Tomorrow online congress organized by Barcelona Hub from November 9th to 20th. But of course, the current head of global football development of FIFA values the organization of these type of events. And yes, of course, Arsene Wenger is a fan of it. So he's going to be addressing a lot of issues. And FC Barcelona, of course, are honoring our boss, because of course, he is the legendary Arsene Wenger. Deserves respect. But moving on, Willian tweets out, match day, hashtag UEL, hashtag Arsenal, hashtag Europa League, hashtag W12, hashtag Gunners, hashtag Vamos, hashtag Emirates Stadium. So Arsenal, Willian is ready, are Malda ready? But let's end the debate about Mason Greenwood and Bukayo Saka, ladies and gentlemen. Of course, let me just pull this over. Yes, so if you can see, 5 appearances for each, 1 goal for Bukayo Saka, 42% shot accuracy, 25 for Mason Greenwood, 6 tackles made, 1 tackle made, 173 passes to 100 passes of Mason Greenwood, 4 interceptions according to 2 for Greenwood, 13 crosses and 3 crosses for Mason Greenwood. So yes, things don't look that good when you compare these two wonder kids. But moving on, well, Rhys Nelson is definitely about to miss the game against Molde tonight because with a minor knee injury, my goodness, I was wanting to see him play for Arsenal, but let's see, not today. But moving on, the Premier League to abandon unpopular pay-per-view charges for matches from next week at least until the end of 2020. Well, that's because the biggest reason for that has been the lockdown 2.0, yeah? That's what has caused it. But moving on, well, also let's talk about Marcel Lucassen. Well, of course, if you don't know who that is, Marcel Lucassen is Arsenal's academy head of coach and player development, is the latest backroom staff to leave Arsenal. Another cut down of the job because Lucassen leaves for personal reasons and is replaced by Luke Hobbs as head of academy coaching. Yes, so that is for personal reasons that he is being relieved of his duties. He asked for it, so he gets it. But moving on, these were the news of the day. I hope you enjoyed whatever came your way. All the views and news and everything about Arsenal comes back from every single day twice. So sit back, relax, and enjoy all the news that comes to this platform. I will see you in the next one. And don't forget to subscribe. We are on a mission of reaching 15,000 subscribers. Help us reach there, of course. And in return, we are going to give you daily Arsenal content. Cheers. I'll see you in the next one. Don't forget to support Arsenal. Arsenal versus Molde. There is not going to be a watch along tonight because, of course, I'm dang busy. Well, it's all about the patients that I've been handling, and I just don't want to miss out on tomorrow because, of course, the game starts at 1:30 a.m. in India and it ends by 3:30, and I have to go as early as 5 a.m. tomorrow, so I just can't risk it. But cheers, I'll see you in the next one, and of course, we will discuss about it in the coming lives. I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.